would be my overall view on all 11 questions, Colorado. So 3:39 in the p.m. 2020, September 13th. So this is for the general election coming up November 3rd or 4th. We got written ballots, so we get a whole month to actually look at all these issues and take our time and, you know, actually do our due diligence as citizens and vote for what we actually believe to be the best policy here going forward. So Amendment C, Colorado, you gotta vote yes. Okay, you don't have to vote yes. It's not as, you know, as big as some of the other things. There are bigger, more important, Amendment 77, you know, I want yes to that too. But is it that important to give maximum wages or wagers to Cripple Creek at Central City at Blackhawk? Is that Cripple Creek? Do they need the casinos they need? Is that the most important? No, it's not a priority. It's just that, do you believe this? Do you believe that? Yes or no? And the answer is yes, I do. So Amendment C is about bingo and raffles and about the nonprofits or the, not nonprofits, but it was the charitable organizations. So I think it's nonprofit, maybe charitable nonprofits, I don't know. But apparently, if you're a nonprofit or a charitable organization, you can only have, you know, bingo and raffles. That's the only thing you can do to make money. You can't actually have slot machines. So we're going to give Cripple Creek slot machines, but we're not going to give La Puente or, you know, these nonprofit, good heart, probably churches. I think churches for some reason, bingos. But they also, they can't pay. They have to be volunteers. They're charitable organizations, so therefore the employees have to be volunteers. And it takes 5 years before they can even get the bingo money to begin with. And so what the yes vote does is it allows nonprofits to apply for a bingo raffle license after existing for 3 years instead of 5 years. It would also allow charitable organizations to hire workers for those games and pay up to minimum wage. So they're not hired workers, right? It's not like a part-time job, but it will be if they're paying them. So I think that I'm okay with the idea, but I do feel like there's going to be some, the courts are going to have to do something with that. But the bingo, pool tabs, so a no vote keeps the five-year requirement in place. No, you got to be a charitable organization for 5 years, and then you can go ahead and play bingo. You're not going to play no bingo until 5 years, you understand? And it keeps that provision that nonprofits are run by unpaid volunteers with the organization. No. The nonprofit, it's unpaid volunteers. That's all that is nonprofit. You're allowed to pay. Nonprofit just means you're not making money from, so you could pay a salary to somebody. But apparently, you know, unpaid volunteers. Denver State, the state of Denver, this is a, you know, a referendum, not an initiative, not the people's. This is, they put Amendment C on the ballot, so apparently they couldn't figure this shit out up in Denver. So they're like, hey, can you figure it out for us? So I say yes. I say yes. It's not an enthusiastic, you know, huge yes. It's just kind of like, we're going to let Cripple Creek take people's mortgages and college accounts. No maximum, you know, wagers at all. Just $1 million bet, sure. And these homeless nonprofit groups, these charitable organizations, you know, churches or whatever, they want to play a little bingo. The big thing that pisses me off about Cripple Creek is we're letting Cripple Creek make all that goddamn, there's 64 counties. They're making all the fucking money. So the rest of the state needs to make some of that money. And the rest of the, you know, state needs to get their beak wet. Cripple Creek is helping their community college. They're helping their counties. They're helping their local cities. But what about the rest of Colorado? And so I feel like Amendment C allows, you know, nonprofits or charitable organizations, which matters, you know, that's depending on their business law, whatever a charitable organization is or a nonprofit or what have you. So I would vote yes, let the homeless nonprofits play a little bingo. Who gives a shit? Pay their elderly $2 an hour. Give them a little something to eat on, right? It's hard to volunteer. Just volunteer to be volunteer. We're American capitalists. You got to make a dollar or two. And it's, like I said, it's not like part-time or nothing, but just maybe you can eat on, you know, you worked for a day. Can I have a meal? Nope, you got to pay $10. But shit, I worked all day. I don't care. But I worked 10 hours. That would be $100 if it was $10 an hour. Nope, that's, hey, we're a non-profit. We have to, you know, I get to get paid. But when it comes to, what is this? Hello? So 1-330-564-7211 from Ohio. They didn't want nothing. They didn't want none. So I got one reservation. Just, you know, notice how we're witnessing an ethical slide. Well, the people of Cripple Creek, you know, get to have casinos and, you know what, crime and prostitution. Prostitution is fine. Crime, no, that's no good. People got rights, throw the money away, but it's stupid. It's irresponsible. What a fucking waste. Go buy some lumber. Build a porch. Build a house. Build a fence. I wouldn't want a casino in my town. I'd educate everybody about staying away from it. And if, you know, you're a friend or family and you got a problem, I'd be like, you know, casinos are, they just bring in vice, you know, and crime, mafia. You know, maybe we should preempt it, right, by allowing prostitution, and the odds are in the house's favor. That's how they profit. So by fucking over as many dumb motherfuckers who, you know, thinks they can beat the casino. Oh, you know what I think? What are you thinking today? What are you thinking right now? You know, I think I could beat the casino. They got that buffet. Okay, you know, sometimes they bring in, you know, entertainment and talent, and they can have food and shit. But all that is just to bring you in, so you'll say, okay, I'll play a little bit of the slot machines. All right. What'd you do all day? Just sat on my ass and played a bunch of fucking slot machines. That's, you know, you have a better chance of going to your neighbor's house and flipping a coin for a dollar. And, you know, maybe you lose a buck, maybe he wins a buck. It's no big fucking deal. But you go to the casino, they're going to take everything that you got and nobody's going to give a shit. So, yeah. And, what's the chances of winning at a casino? 1 in 1,000,000? Play the fucking lotto, you know, shit. So, just, you know, it's like, well, Cripple Creek is, you know, they're all a bunch of fucking gambling, you know, alcoholics, so how come we're not going to let the churches and the non-profits and charitable organizations be a bunch of gambling alcoholics, too? Bingo raffles, fine, you know, do your pull tabs, do your fucking bingos, you know, do it in 3 years instead of five, I don't, you know, whatever, I don't care, it's new. No skin off my teeth. So, what do I think about the overall, you know, election? I am quite excited, actually. There's two main things I'm really excited about. I'm excited about Proposition 114. I'm also excited about Proposition 1, let's see, the one with the medical family leave, 114. So, I'm excited about Proposition 114. Wait a second. They're both 114? I got the numbers are wrong. But anyways, the Grey Wolves and the Medical Family Leave. I like both of those. I like the Medical Family Leave, and I like the Grey Wolf Restoration Program. So those are my two favorite ones. When you look at, you know, just a couple, you know, here's some knowledge. Colorado, Algeria. They got medical family leave, meaning if you have a baby, they got paid maternal leave. The mother can go home, and for 14 weeks, right, 4 into 14, 3.5. So for 3.5 months in Algeria, they got paid maternal leave. We don't have paid maternal leave in America, but Algeria, they got 14 weeks. In Angola, there's 13 weeks of paid maternal leave. In Benin, they got 14 weeks paid maternal leave. Botswana, 12 weeks. Paid maternal leave. Burkina Faso, 12 weeks. Burundi, 14 weeks. Burkina Faso, 12 weeks. Burundi, 14 weeks. Cameroon, and yet Colorado, nothing. America, nothing. There's even a couple states, probably California, New York, and some other ones which have, you know, medical family leave. It just makes sense. Japan, I think, does it best, and I'll actually, that's a whole other video. But it's just like universal health care, it's one of those universal education. It's the whole goddamn fucking world has, you know, medical family leave, and yet for some reason the richest nation in the world when it comes to our babies because it's seeding money for newborns. It's to make sure the father and the mother bond with the baby so they're not just throwing their baby in the trash and not giving a shit about it and not, you know, beating the fuck out of it. All of that, they actually love it. The baby is just going to piss and shit and cry. So it needs to love it as its, you know, the crappy, vulnerable bullshit self. That way it will always love that stupid, crappy, crybaby, you know, shitter, shit and crybaby son of a bitch. And, so yeah, it makes logical sense. You should bond, and not just the mother, but the father. And if the mother wants to work and split the time, or actually just give all the time to the father, it doesn't matter. However that family wants to organize, the mother and the father could split the time. And I think if they split the time, maybe evenly, maybe 75-25, if they just work out some sort of time frame or timetable, maybe they should get, you know, a discount. Maybe they should get another 2 months on top of it for being able to work together. And figuring out what they think is fair. You know, it's their marriage. They get to decide who gets to stay home. And it's important for the father to bond with the baby, too. In Japan, it's about 50-50. It's almost 50-50, which it feels like it should be, right? You got, what, a year's worth of paid vacation? Well, shit, that should be, you know, the mother needs to spend time with the kid, but so does the father. And which one's more important? I don't know. I don't know if you could say one is more, you know, important than the other. They're both, you know, equally important, and so therefore they should equally benefit with the Family Medical Leave Program. So I'm really excited about that. I'm also really excited about the Gray Wolves program in the Rocky Mountain National Park. I probably should just do an overview for a different... But I guess real quick and see. No on Amendment 76, states rights, so what? You got to go with an ID now, you know, to vote. I've already, you know, I got a driver's license. I've already proved what I need to prove. It just seems like they want to go ahead and make it, you know, you got to have Social Security and your birth certificate, and you got to have an eye retina scan and go ahead and do a fingerprint. My God, just to fucking vote? This is definitely trying to stop people from voting, and we shouldn't. It's a states' rights issue. I like Colorado more than I like America, so this is the election for Colorado and the people of Colorado, and we shouldn't solely, you know, beautiful, wonderful, pure, innocent Colorado with dirty America. We should change every citizen to only a citizen. That gets us under federal jurisdiction. Let Colorado be destroyed by the Coloradans. We don't need the feds coming in here destroying us. We can destroy ourselves. Number two, yes on proposition, whatever. I think it's 114. I'm definitely in favor of 114. I don't know which one, but the medical family medical leave, 12 to 16 weeks, 3 to 4 months. If you're not for health and family leave, then you could just go ahead and leave my Colorado. Right, 3 to 4 months. Even Jordan, 10 weeks, they pay 100% of the paycheck of the job that you're in for 10 weeks. In Jordan, 2.5 months, not Colorado, not America, but in Jordan. So no on proposition EE, should we increase taxes on vaping and tobacco and nicotine, a sin tax? No, look at the taxes, it's too much. Yes, on Proposition 116, should we reduce the state income tax rate from 4.63 to 4.55, to a reduction of 0.08%? Yeah, we should. It's almost like, shit, they're asking us, are they going to do that every year? I mean, slowly but surely, right, we'll make sure we'll become more fiscally responsible. The Democrats should actually preempt it. Go ahead. Yeah, drop it by 0.08% every year. And that means it's 4.5%. That means it would take, you know what, 20, it would take 100 years to go to zero. So that's like, God, that should be the liberal, you know, tax and spend. It's like they're smart. It'd be smarter to do. Vote no on Amendment B because the Gallagher Amendment is the shit. Vote yes on Proposition 113 because fuck the Electoral College. Yes on Proposition 115. There should be a prohibition on late-term abortions. You waited to 8.5 months before, why not a C-section? Because you really want to kill the fetus, huh? You just like dying to kill the fetus. You don't want no C-section. You just want to pretend you never had the damn thing. How about the C-section? And see if it's survive on its own. That's the language of Roe v. Wade. So if it's viable outside the mother, then it wasn't your life to, you know, just because it's trapped inside your body, then that means either you have a serious operation with an abortion or you have a serious operation with the birth of the child. So why not give the chance for the fetus to be able to breathe on its own? If it could breathe on its own and there's a family out there that wants to adopt it, why are you pushing to hurry up and make sure you kill that damn fetus? It's fucking bullshit. I want to make sure that whole I brought you into this world, I could take you out, is a bunch of horse shit, you know? It's bullshit on its face, and it should always be bullshit. Yeah, you brought me into this world, now I'm here. Now I got all the human rights, American Colorado rights. Parents cannot murder their kids, no. They can't murder their kids at 90 years of age. They can't murder their kids at 15, nor at 2. Not at all. So, a parent who gives up their kid for adoption, then they come back later thinking they could take the kid. No, that's bullshit, you know? And then when it comes to child abuse, you want to talk about ladies and, hey, you can't regulate my body? Well, what about child abuse? That's spankings, violent assaults. Talk about regulating bodies. There's a lot of child abuse in America. So, I need to hear people that say that you should have an abortion up to 9 months, that you're not in favor of child abuse, or that you don't believe that you can murder your own kids, because that's what it sounds like you're telling me. There is a limit. I believe there is a limit. If they would have done 8 months, then I would have been in favor of it. But Colorado's, there is no, you know, up to 9 months, you can have an abortion up to 9 months. And I believe in some limit. It's probably between 6 and 7. And so because I believe in some limit, you know, I believe that, you know, the group and the people that's doing this is, you know, they might want to do it even farther. But they're doing 4.5 months. So I believe in a line, I believe in some line, and there isn't a line. And so that's why I'm in, you know, voting in favor of it. Not enthusiastic, I am pro-choice. It draws a line at 4.5 months, but that's pro-choice, right? That's 4.5 months that you can get an abortion. So yes, on Proposition 114, or whatever, the gray wolves, I'm in favor of releasing the gray wolves. I'm in favor of the Family and Medical Leave Act. So when it comes to, you know, child abuse and making sure you're talking about killing kids and shit, the vote in favor of the Family Medical Leave Act, because that's saying that you do care about children. When they're born, then you're saying that here's, you know, 3 months of pay for the parent to make sure that that parent, that kid gets a fighting chance. That little Coloradan kid, that little tiny Coloradan, he's going to grow up and he's going to be a voter and he's going to, you know, be an adult and he's going to, you don't want that, what, that one white fucking boy. What, that one white guy, he killed his whole fucking family, right? Colorado, right up there in what, Colorado Springs, right? Fucking, that's our Florida. Colorado Springs is our Florida. What, so much crazy shit, nothing surprising. Oh, that happened in Colorado? Oh, okay. Wait, that happened? Where did that happen? Oh, Colorado Springs, okay. Well, that makes sense, of course. It's Colorado Springs. That's a fucking weird place. A lot of weird people and a lot of weird shit happens in, more shit happens in Colorado Springs than Denver, and Denver's got so much more people. It's like, what is up with Colorado Springs? And yes on Amendment C, yes on Amendment 77, yes on Proposition 117. So that's my overall take. This is four, I'm so sorry, this is 3:57 in the p.m., Sunday, September 13th, 2020. I'm John Masters. This is Southern Colorado, Luvetti, near the Lobato Bridge, southwestern Castile County. And that's my overall view, and that's also the, what was the, Amendment 77 or so? What was it? What was I talking about? So the casinos, yeah, let the casinos wager whatever, but also the churches and the nonprofits, they could play bingo. Let them eat cake, right? Let them play bingo. Let them eat some cake. Let them play bingo. Let them have pool tabs, okay? No big deal. Jesus Christ. Let them pay their elderly a buck or two, right? My God, what is the big deal on that? And that was, let's see. It's not the Tabor one. It's not Amendment 77. It's Amendment C. So yes on Amendment C, yes on Amendment 77, and also yes on Proposition 117, extend Tabor. Tabor is a good thing. And liberal progressives, you know, I want liberal progressives to stay within their limits. And I just, that's a lot. I believe, I realize that I'm supporting a lot of the conservative issues on this. But you know what? It's almost like I love Colorado and I want Colorado to succeed. So I don't want Colorado to, you know, fucking lose themselves because we got ourselves a nice little sort of progressive, conservative slash progressive wonderland here. And yeah, I don't want us to fuck up. I think we're doing good, and I want to make sure we are cautious. So in a way, I guess I'm being a little bit conservative because I want to protect the revolution, the marijuana legalization, the consolidation of marijuana legalization, and I want it to stay here forever and ever, and that we should show solidarity for the other 13, you know, legalization, pro-legalization states too. But anyways, yeah, extend Tabor, go ahead and release some gray wolves, and let's get some family medical leave, Colorado. Peace.